loves, welcome back to my channel. For those of you that are brand new to my channel, my name is Candace and welcome to my journey. So this week will be my last pregnancy update and it's definitely bittersweet. I am actually a little sad because after waiting for so long to be pregnant and have a pregnancy experience and being so excited to share it with you guys, I'm just a little sad the pregnancy is coming to an end, but I'm so excited to finally meet our baby girl after so many years of waiting. So just really a bittersweet kind of like feeling. Just really grateful for this experience and just got a little sentimental this week, kind of thinking over, you know, thinking about the journey and just where I've come from and where I am now and, you know, how much work it was to get where I am now and just you know, just finally being at the point where we're about to meet our little miracle baby. So for this week, the same symptoms. I've been having a lot of the Braxton Hicks contractions, and so I do have a scheduled C-section date, and so I'm just hoping that I can make it to that scheduled date. But if not, I'm just gonna be open and ready to, you know, for whatever that happens, and I'm just making sure that I'm safe and baby girl enters the world safely. So I am so excited. We got everything done that we needed to get done. I finished the nursery and all the baby stuff put together. And so there's only a few small things that I want to finish before she comes, but if those things don't get done, then they just don't get done. So I'm hoping we make it to our scheduled C-section date. But you know, I have been having a little bit more consistent Braxton Hicks contraction, so we'll just have to see. I'm just really trying to take it easy. Trying to rest is so hard for me to sit still because I just get so bored. So I'm always like up doing something. So everybody's like making me rest over these, you know, next couple of days. But overall, I just feel really good. I am just really tired and just ready. I'm just ready to meet baby girl, ready for this season and this journey to come to an end and ready for a new journey to begin. So I will be taking off a few weeks from YouTube after the baby is born, but I do have some videos recorded and edited already for you guys. So I am ready to get back into recording and editing. And so I am gonna take a little bit of time off. So I won't post here right away when the baby's born. So if you do wanna know some of those like updates, then you should be following me on Instagram or Facebook, and all of my social media is down below in the description box. So if you're not following me on social media, I would suggest that you do that if you want to know, you know, what's going on, so you can kind of keep up with everything, because it's going to be a lot harder for me to record things and upload them here, and so social media will just be a lot simpler. Yes, everything just still feels so surreal. Even though I'm so close to the end of the pregnancy, it still just feels like I can't believe it. I'm just grateful, just grateful for this experience. So this week's pregnancy update is just really, you know, just a lot of the contractions I'm feeling. Just really, really tired, having a really hard time sleeping. I probably sleep, I don't even know how many hours a night now. I'm waking up every 2 or 3 hours. So I'm never getting a restful night of sleep, but I try to nap during the day just to kind of make sure that I'm getting the rest that I need. I feel like baby girl has been moving a whole lot more, and so I don't know if that means she's ready. She's trying to find her way, and I keep saying, don't go towards the light, baby bubs, just wait a few more days. So we'll see. Like, you know, of course babies don't care about your scheduled C-section date, but you know, whatever day she decides to come, we'll be excited and we'll be ready for her. So I'm just thinking back to some of the, you know, like the first transfer we did that failed, and then when we were trying to decide if we were gonna do another IVF cycle, and I really didn't wanna do another one, but we ended up doing the second IVF cycle, and then I had all of those delays. I know you guys remember I had to do the somatohistogram, and then I had to do the ERA test, and I was just like delayed every month, and I was so frustrated. And then I finally got to transfer day, and we transferred our little embryo, and then I found out I was pregnant. Like, just thinking back to all that stuff just makes me just so sentimental. It makes me just feel so emotional, because it has been a long journey, and the journey finally coming to an end. So I want to thank you guys so much again for all of your support, not only in my IVF journey, but in my pregnancy journey. Just so grateful for my little family here. And you guys have made this experience just amazing because I've had all of your support and all of you guys cheering me on. So I'll definitely let you guys know when baby girl is here on social media. There will be a little bit of a delay on my YouTube channel, but I won't leave you guys hanging. And like I said, I do have a couple of videos that have been really like highly requested that I've already filmed and edited, so I'll have those up for you guys so you guys won't even know that I'm gone. If you are not yet subscribed to my channel, please be sure to hit that subscribe button down below. I'll be back next time with another video. Bye.